Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. Throughout history, there has always been a few things that you can count on. The first is death, the second is taxes, and the third is a relatively strong US dollar. Sure, there have been bumps in the road, but generally speaking, the US dollar has always been a pretty safe bet. In today's video, we're going to talk about something that will shake the world to its core if it happens, and something that is being increasingly speculated about over the past 12 months, and that is the collapse of the US dollar. Before we get into the video, please do like and subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell icon to stay up to date with all our new content that we have coming. Okay, let's get into the video. Economists are increasingly speculating that something unthinkable could happen, and that the US is facing a dollar collapse by the end of 2021. Some are even predicting that there is over a 50% chance of a double-dip recession in the next 12 months. In the past, this would seemingly be a crazy idea. But in the post-pandemic global economy, perhaps this scenario is not quite too far-fetched as people may think. Analysts put much of this increased risk down to the final policies of the new US President, Joe Biden. One such example is the views of Werner Kremer, who is an economist at the Lazard Asset Management Consulting Company. Werner states that the American crisis and the rise of the United States and the weakness of the US dollar in recent months could lead to a real currency crisis in the worst-case scenario. Werner is not alone in this analysis. Whilst not everyone agrees, even if it doesn't come to a fully-fledged collapse, it remains the case that there will be significant consequences around the world if the dollar weakens. This will impact Americans, Europe, those that pin their economy on the dollar, depositors, and investors. Why do they think this is? Part of the reason for this pessimistic view is the likelihood of increased national debt, which is likely to result from Joe Biden's plan to implement the so-called America's Salvation Plan. This is predicted to be one of the first policies he will make as the new US president. In December, the US approved a $600 lump sum payment to Americans. But under Biden's plan, they will see an additional $1,400 added, with unemployment benefits rising to $400. As a result of this proposed policy, economists are increasingly raising their forecasts that debts will spike. Added to this plan, there are hundreds of billions of dollars that are put aside to support states, communities, and schools, whilst also adding infrastructure development, research, and clean energy. The total cost of this package is $1.9 trillion, or around 9% of the productivity of the US economy. So, what does extra spending mean? Well, to put simply, even without additional spending of Salvation Plan, US debt is already on track to increase to about 134% of GDP this year. To put it into perspective, this is roughly the same figure that Italy had before their own crisis. However, when factoring in the costs of Biden's plans, the debt levels and percentage will inevitably be higher. What does this mean for the budget deficit? In 2020, the budget deficit had already soared to an eye-watering 15% of GDP. It was previously assessed that 2021 would see it fall to under 10%. But if these proposed plans are implemented, then it is likely that the budget deficit will remain around 15%, which would mean a total debt of around 140% of GDP. So, I assume this means there is probably going to be consequences? Indeed. What this is likely to mean is that the high budget deficit will push the US trade deficit wider. And when that is aired with the Federal Reserve's policy of keeping the printing press on and off, it is likely to see the dollar fall in value. Analysts are speculating that over the course of 2021, the dollar could fall by 15 to 20%. So, is this the end of the world as we know it? Perhaps, but probably not. You see, the dollar has been growing sharply since the beginning of the coronavirus, as investors stormed in to buy up the currency, which was seen as something of a safe haven. But this had the effect of overvaluing the dollar by up to 20%. And although it has dipped slightly since the highs in 2020, Experts suggest that it is still overvalued by approximately 8 to 10%. So a further dip or evening out of this would not necessarily spell doom for the world. True, this would not mean a collapse, and Holger Schmieding, the chief economist at Berenberg Bank, agrees with this opinion. For now, he said, even some growth of the American currency is possible. So the market program of such is rather positive for the dollar, he said. Phew, that's good. Yes, it is. But that's only half the story. Although the dollar might not crash immediately as the world recovers, this is likely to lead to investors taking out their money from these safe havens and from the United States. Therefore, it is predicted that in the medium term, there will be a serious and significant weakening of the dollar. What will happen if this does play out? Firstly, there are likely to be significant implications for the European economy. For a start, exports to the United States will become more expensive. And added to that, in the capital market, a weak dollar will also lead to shifts. It is speculated by experts that cynical stocks will benefit most, particularly companies that were particularly hard hit by the initial downturn, as they tend to do particularly well at the beginning of the business cycle. It can be argued that this also applies to the so-called valued stocks, i.e. the securities of companies with a stable business, which don't generally tend to experience large jumps in trading volumes. There is potential for precious metals to also benefit from their traditional function of protecting against inflation and growing demand due to economic growth. Experts suggest that this particularly applies to investments in platinum and palladium, which are assigned a central role in the Joe Biden program in the context of the development of green technologies. What is the worst-case scenario? Well, if the dollar was to implode and suddenly collapse, it would undoubtedly create global economic turmoil. We don't know for sure what would happen, but I would guess that investors would rush to purchase other fiat currencies, such as the euro, as well as bet heavily on other assets such as gold. It would see demand for treasuries plummet, and there would be significant rise in the US interest rates and a corresponding hike in US import prices, ultimately causing inflation. In the long term, the cost of inflation, high interest rates, and market volatility would suffocate possible business growth, leading to increased unemployment whilst sending the United States back into recession or perhaps even a depression. Can I protect myself against this? Yes, sort of. Although the collapse of the dollar would create global economic turmoil, you can respond to this risk by keeping your investments mobile, which means you can shift them as needed. That is the best way to help survive a dollar collapse. Well, guys, that's just about it for today. I hope that you found this video on the collapse of the US dollar to be helpful, useful, and informative. As always, these are just my opinions. And as such, anything I cover in this or any other of my videos should not be treated as explicit financial, trading, or otherwise investment advice. And I always recommend you do your own research before making any type of investment. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one. We hope you found this video useful and would love it if you could like and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date of all the new content. If you want to be ahead of the curve and learn the coins which have the most potential to 10 times, 100 times, and even 1,000 times of this market cycle, make sure to download the Crypto Fast Start Guide today and watch the free webinar which will give away 3 coins which have this kind of potential. Visit www.cryptofaststart.com or simply click the link below in the description. If you already have crypto and you want to get a $250 crypto bonus and earn up to 8% APY, head on over to BlockFi by clicking the link below in the description. And finally, head on over to crypto.com and get the rewards-based debit card. You also get $50 in free crypto when you sign up. You can get up to 8% cash back by spending money on this card, which is awesome. Simply click on the link in the description below to get your $50 in crypto and your card today. And that is all for today, guys. If you liked the video, then hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified about whenever we drop a video. Comment down below what are your views on cryptocurrency. Also, share it with your friends and others to help them learn about cryptocurrency so they can decide whether to invest in it or not. Bye, guys. See you later. And until then, stay tuned for another video. And all that's left to say is thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon on the next one.